You know, one of the things that I really enjoy with the work that we do here at Couples Academy is the fact that we're able to make an impact on people's lives and help bring about some change and transformation in them individually as well as in their relationship. But one of the things that really grieves me and sets me back emotionally is when I get the dreaded call or the dreaded text or the dreaded email that suggests he did it again. She's involved again. In essence, they're talking about the fact that their partner is in an affair. And so either they have rekindled an affair that came to an end, or they're off yet into another illicit relationship with someone else. And so today I want to talk to you from the topic, you are going to cheat again unless. So in essence, there are very specific behaviors and changes and shifts that you must make. And if you don't make them, the probability of you cheating again skyrockets. So let's go through the list. Number one, you will cheat again unless you change your mindset. See, the reality is so many people have held on to the same mentality, the same way of thinking, the same perspective as they had when they were in the affair. And if you think the same way, it's quite possible that you'll wind up doing the same thing because you have a tendency of justifying, of rationalizing, of minimizing behavior that compromises the integrity of the relationship. And so it's quite often that I hear people say, well, it wasn't really cheating. You know, yeah, I had sex with her one time, so it's not like it's an affair. Or, yeah, we exchanged conversations and we went out and, you know, I didn't tell my spouse about it and we shared text messages and pictures. But that's not really cheating. You know, so in our minds, we have our own definition for what we do. And as long as we can create our own definition and have our own perspective about it, it somehow minimizes the impact in our minds that it should have on our partner. And why can't our partner just get over it? Why can't they just move forward? Like, it wasn't that bad. And until you begin to understand the gravity of what you've done, then you will not change. If you do not see it as a sin, if you do not see it as a violation, if you do not see it as something that could potentially destroy the foundation of your marriage and family, then you will continue down a path that led to the situation that you're in the first place. So you gotta change your mindset. You gotta change the way you think. I say this all the time. You have to begin to establish a new definition, okay, a new perspective about infidelity, affairs, cheating, whatever term you want to use. But as long as you think the same way, you'll get the same result. Number two, you are going to continue to cheat unless you agree to getting help. And help comes in many forms. Number one, finding a good therapist or coach or counselor that can guide you through a process that will lead to your personal and relational restoration. Number two, why not join a support group? There's so many support groups that will help people who have issues and concerns and challenges that you're struggling with, and somehow being in that environment allows you to begin to think differently and feel differently. You realize that you're not alone on an island all by yourself, and there is a pathway that leads to your change and transformation. A person who is open to change, a person who is open to getting help, realizes that they need to be on a constant path of personal growth and self-development. That comes by reading and researching and watching videos. You know, what's most common is that the betrayed spouse is the one that goes on this quest for knowledge. And they're staying up watching videos, reading articles, reading blogs, going to seminars, reading books, doing all types of education to understand the impact of an affair. Yet, the one who committed the affair, generally speaking, does not have the same thirst, hunger, or passion for it. But you know that there's an indication that you're on the right path when you take the topic of infidelity very seriously and you dive deep into it to understand all of the complexities involved to figure out how you got caught up in the situation that you are in. Number three, you will continue to cheat unless you search out and discover the root cause of the affair. In other words, understanding the why of the affair. Why did this happen in the first place? If I haven't clearly determined why it happened, then the possibility of it happening again is very likely. So, was it because I was emotionally disconnected and I didn't get the attention that I was looking for? Is it because sex became an issue? So either my spouse has an aversion to sex, or I have such a high drive that I thought that my wife could not fulfill me or my husband could not gratify me? Was it because I was looking for a deeper connection that I could not find with my partner? Was it because I'm starving for attention and wasn't getting the attention, the affection, in the time that I was looking for in my partner? You know, was it because of just, you know, self-esteem issues and poor value of self? Was it because I didn't feel like I could be a man in my own home or a woman in my own home? Was it because of financial pressures and challenges or social issues? Like, you have to discover what the reason is. Because if you don't go to the root of it, it can happen again and again and again and again and again. And not really discovering the why is like putting a Band-Aid on a gashing wound. It doesn't properly heal or address the issue, and that pain or that issue that led to the affair hasn't been uprooted, it hasn't been removed, it's still lying dormant within you, and anything can trigger it. And here we are on a path of destruction all over again. So you've got to understand your why. Number three, you're gonna cheat again unless you stop the blame game. Now, this is very common, where a person doesn't take ownership for their behavior, but they will blame their partner for what he or she has failed to do. You didn't give me enough time. You didn't give me enough attention. You didn't give me enough sex. You don't know how to talk to me. Like, literally every reason and justification has nothing to do with self and has everything to do with how their partner fell short in giving them what they needed or meeting their need, and that drove them to cheat. Oftentimes they may blame the affair partner. Like, I hear this all the time. Well, how did the affair begin? Well, she approached me, and you know, she kept soliciting me, and he wouldn't leave me alone, and he kept coming on to me. Like, there was no ownership of the involvement that, you know, that particular person played in the pursuit or in the chase or in the intrigue or in the desire. It was all about what the affair partner did and how, because of their weakness, they were swooped into something that they did not want to be in. And so, rather than taking ownership for one's involvement, everything is the fault of the affair partner. Another thing that a person has a tendency to do is to blame circumstances. You know, pressure on my job, you know, my financial situation, the government crisis. It's just always something. And until you own what you've done, then you're bound to do it again and again and again. Because the reality is, the relationship will never be perfect. Circumstances will never be ideal. There will always be something that can be used to justify one's bad choices and bad behavior. But until you own it for yourself, you will continue to cheat. Number four, you are going to continue to cheat unless you are incredibly open and honest. Openness simply means you're not closed off. You're not clandestine. You're not living a secret life. You're not compartmentalizing aspects of who you are, where you show up one way with your spouse and another way with your affair partner or with the world. No, you are an open book. You're living a life of transparency. You're completely vulnerable. You're welcoming your partner into your private world. You see the difference? And so what happens is, there's so many people who hold on to secrets and live in secrecy, and it's guised under private. I'm just a private person. But your privacy is hiding your integrity, your intent, and your motive to keep things from your partner. And so if you're ever finding yourself doing that, then you're susceptible to cheating again. The other thing is being completely honest. Honesty, as they say, is the best policy. You have many schools of thought. Some people suggest you don't tell your partner everything. You don't involve them in every thought and in every concern. You keep things. And if you're not honest about your past, if you're not honest about your feelings, if you're not participating in current honesty, where you're living a life of transparency, you can know who I'm with and what I'm doing and where I'm at. Because the reality is, people who have nothing to hide, hide nothing. So I can be honest about my whereabouts. They're honest about their future plans and intentions. They're engaging in radical honesty. And that level of honesty really shines a spotlight on your life always. And so when there's a spotlight on your life, you can't hide in dark places and do inappropriate things. So openness and honesty is key to never cheating again. Number five, you're gonna cheat again unless you continue to work on the relationship. Listen, the affair happened for one or two reasons. Either something was going wrong within you, something was going wrong within the relationship, or a combination of the two. But oftentimes, affairs will shine a light on all of the unresolved issues and the relational dynamics that are problematic. And when it exposes what's wrong, your desire to work on and work through these issues is an indication that you won't cheat again. But if you're not willing to do the work, if you're not willing to unpack communication issues and things that have you struggle with, intimacy issues, finances, all of these different things, affection, domestic support, family commitment. And so if you don't take the time to work on your relationship and work through these issues, there's a high possibility that you'll cheat again, because in most cases, people have used relationship issues as a justification for the affair in the first place. And so working through issues reduces the probability that you'll cheat again. And finally, number six, you are going to cheat again unless you feel the five emotions of change. In order for change to occur, there's got to be a stimulus, something that moves you forward in a direction of change and transformation. And usually there are these internal mood states that we have that trigger us to act. These five emotional mood states are critically important, and if you don't feel them, then there's a possibility that you'll cheat again. But if you feel them and embrace them and use them to your advantage, it can result in complete transformation. And finally, number six, you are going to cheat again unless you feel the five emotions of change. Now, we're gonna do a more in-depth video on what these five emotions are, but really quickly, number one is empathy. Number two is compassion. Number three is remorse. Number four is a healthy dose of guilt. And number five, a healthy dose of shame. When these five emotions are experienced and embodied and truly felt, it begins to allow you to have a level of understanding for what it is your partner's going through, where you place yourself in their shoes and you experience what they experience, you embody what they're embracing, and that makes a huge difference. All of my research generally concludes this, that it's not your promises, it's not your declarations, it's not all of the verbal affirmations that you make about what you will never do again. But when you begin to feel what your partner feels, you never want to do what caused the feeling in the first place. And it causes you to change course in another direction. And cheating is not even a probability, it's not a possibility, it's an absolute never again behavior, because you understand the impact of your partner. So these are the things that you must do in order to never cheat again. And so look, if you are the one that cheated, don't fool yourself. Don't live in self-deception to think that you'll never cheat again simply because you made a decision. How many times have you made a decision and found yourself in the same situation? So follow these six specific steps. Protect yourself, protect the integrity of your marriage.